Hey, what's up, everybody, and welcome back to Newsdose. And here recently, we've been talking about the success that Xbox has had over on the PC platform, specifically when it comes to Steam. They do actually own 12 different games that was the best-selling entries for the entire year over on Steam. But, well, a little bit more information has come out since then that really reveals just how successful Xbox has been over on Steam. Yeah, Xbox Game Pass is not the only place that they're having success, so we will definitely talk about that one today. And then also, we are going to be taking a look at some of the best-selling independent games over on the Nintendo Switch, so stay tuned for that one as well. To start this episode off today, though, we do unfortunately have a very serious and saddening topic to talk about, and that is about John Madden, which recently has passed away at the age of 85. I know for a lot of people, John Madden is going to be linked more towards NFL football, as he very well should be. He is an absolute legend when it comes to the NFL. He was drafted by the Philadelphia Eagles, Fly Eagles Fly. He was a head coach, and then later on in life, he was also an NFL commentator and did an absolute fantastic job with that. That's actually how I remember him the most, but he's also had a huge major impact on the game industry as well. Of course, the Madden NFL games developed by EA are actually some of the most successful games on a yearly basis, especially over in the United States. And the truth is that John Madden was a major reason that EA had so much success with this franchise, especially early on. There's been a lot of stories about this specific topic being passed around here in the last couple days, but John Madden actually early on, when it came to this franchise, he was actually only willing to lend his name to this game if EA was willing to make an actual pro football game. And what I mean by that is that apparently EA was originally only going to make a 7-on-7 football game because, you know, computing power was not nearly as powerful back then, so it was a little bit more difficult to get that 11-on-11. But John Madden, he did not like this idea at all, and actually, let's just go and check out what he had to say. He said, "If it was going to be me and going to be pro football, it had to have 22 guys on the screen. If we couldn't have that, we couldn't have a game." So because of that, EA went back to the drawing boards and they made it happen with the 11-on-11 version. And really the rest from there is history. Madden has now cemented itself as one of the most successful video game franchises of all time. And it really all starts with, of course, John Madden. So I really don't think I can do this topic enough justice, but really, rest in peace to the legend, John Madden. Moving on though, we do have some good news to talk about today as well, including some free games over on the Epic Games Store. Now, I know the Epic Games Store has received a lot of criticism throughout its years, but I mean, you can't really argue when it comes to free games. All you really have to do is log on and then just go pick up the games for free. That's a pretty good deal if you ask me. And they're giving some pretty big and just high quality games away here completely for free. And you did hear that right. I'm not just talking about one game here. I'm not talking about two games here, but instead it is an entire trilogy. And in my opinion, it's really just one of the best trilogies that's been made in the last decade or so. And that is for Tomb Raider. You can actually pick up the entire rebooted Tomb Raider trilogy up completely free on the Epic Games Store. And this will be the case until January 6th. So you will have a little time to pick these games up, but I can honestly tell you these games are phenomenal in terms of their story. I love the cinematic gameplay, and visually these games look absolutely gorgeous. Here's kind of the thing though when it comes to the Epic Games Store, because they do actually give free games away quite often when it comes to this storefront, especially when it comes to the holiday period. They've been giving a free game away pretty much every single day, and this is a great tactic to bring more people over to their storefront and everything. But let's say that you're not necessarily into PC gaming. Well, this is just kind of the way I look at it, but we do have the Valve Steam Deck right around the corner, and one thing that I've noticed about that device is that a lot of console gamers seem to be really interested in it as well. So if you are interested in that device and maybe you have it on pre-order and you don't necessarily have a library already built up, well, situations like this where they're giving games away completely for free, well, you can actually just go ahead and put those games in your library, and then when a Steam Deck comes out, well, then you can just go ahead and install the Epic Games Store and then just play those games right out of the gate. Do keep in mind that the Steam Deck allows you to install Windows and other storefronts, so you will be able to play these games on your Steam Deck when that does eventually release. So really, anytime you see free games available on PC, yeah, I would just go ahead and grab them, especially if you have that Steam Deck up for pre-order. Now, speaking of PC, we need to talk about Xbox yet again because they are just having a ton of success over on the Steam storefront. Now, we did talk about this earlier in the week whenever it was revealed that Xbox had 12 of the top 100 best-selling games for the year of 2021 on Steam. But apparently, in terms of new releases, they are equally, if not even more impressive here, because this isn't just games that has been available on Steam for a long period of time, but rather these are all brand new games that have released in the year of 2021. But you can actually see here that in the year of 2021, they have three of the top 12 best-selling games in terms of gross revenue. Now, all of these games here are in complete random order, but if you take a look here, you see Resident Evil Village made the list, Naraka Blade Point, New World, which we all just know how incredible that game has been doing. Then you have Back 4 Blood, Halo Infinite, Battlefield 2042, Valheim, Farming Simulator 22, Mass Effect Legendary Edition, Forza Horizon 5, Age of Empires 4, and then Outriders. This is absolutely incredible. Three of the top 12 best-selling games here are Xbox first-party games, and what that means is that Microsoft was actually one of the best publishers in the year of 2021 over on Steam. And not only that, but all of these games are selling incredibly well despite these games being available on Xbox Game Pass, or more importantly, PC Game Pass. Yes, all of these games are available on PC Game Pass, but even then, these games are among the best selling on the Steam storefront, which is easily the biggest PC storefront for games right now. I mean, if you want to go and take things just a step further, five of these games were actually available in Xbox Game Pass day one, because Outriders as well as Back 4 Blood did release directly into Xbox Game Pass. So there's always kind of been that talk about how Xbox Game Pass hinders game sales, but this really shows the complete opposite yet again. Xbox is making a lot of money on things like Xbox Game Pass and PC Game Pass, of course, but they're also making a lot of money on sales as well, as it very easily shows here with them having three of the top 12 best-selling games. It's just phenomenal what they've been able to achieve this year. I think if there's ever been a question if Xbox made the correct decision to bring their games over to PC, or more importantly, over to Steam, I think that with all the narratives over the last week, I don't really think that there's much of a question anymore. I know that Xbox One had its problems last generation, but it really seems like they have flipped that script. You're seeing them have success really on the console side of things. You're seeing them have success with PC. You're seeing them have success with their subscription services. I mean, Xbox really just has a very, very bright future. And what's kind of scary about this is that we haven't even really scratched the surface of what their first parties can do just yet. I mean, we're just starting to get into those continuous releases with games like Halo Infinite, Forza Horizon, Psychonauts 2, and so on and so forth. But now that they have all of these other studios, they have Bethesda, they have Obsidian Entertainment, they have Ninja Theory, which is working on the incredible looking Hellblade 2. They just have a lot of games in the pipeline. So I think that we're going to kind of see this year in and year out now. I think for the foreseeable future, we're going to start to see Xbox make the best-selling game list on a regular basis. And I just don't think that you can really say Xbox, quote unquote, has no games anymore. It is just amazing to me to see how much they have flipped that script since last generation. And yeah, we're seeing that here on the PC side of things. Next up, let's talk about the Nintendo Switch, as they have now officially revealed the best-selling independent games for the Switch in 2021. And there are a lot of really good games here. Nintendo did actually post an entire video about this topic. I'm so happy that they did that, which we'll kind of get back to here in just a moment. But actually, let's just go and take a look at the list here, which includes Axiom Verge 2, Curse of the Dead Gods, Cyber Shadow, Doki Doki Literature Club Plus, Eastward, Ender Lilies, Islanders Console Edition, Littlewood, Road 96, Slime Rancher Portable Edition, Spelunky 2, Stick Fight The Game, Subnautica Plus Subnautica Below Zero, Tetris Effect Connected, and then also Unpacking. So like I said, there's a lot of really good games here, and it really seems like gamers voted with their wallets in 2021. I can't really point at any games here that didn't necessarily deserve to be on this list. In fact, I was actually really happy to see several of these games make the list, including Spelunky 2. I hadn't really heard many people talk about this game online. It almost felt like people had forgotten that this game even released, but to see it pop up here on the best-selling list, that was really cool to see. Axiom Verge 2. I loved the original Axiom Verge, and even though the second one was a little bit different than what I was probably expecting, it's still a really good game and something that I was happy to see make this list as well. Eastward is absolutely phenomenal. It really has some of the best pixel art I have seen in any video game ever. It's got a cool story, it's got great characters, and I enjoy its gameplay as well. Then there is Ender Lilies. Now, this one is interesting because I hadn't actually heard about this one until here recently, which was a little bit surprising considering one of my favorite genres is actually Metroidvanias. And Ender Lilies, this is a really good Metroidvania, so if you haven't heard about that one before, definitely check that one out. And then the other two, I have to go ahead and say something about Tetris Effect here. I absolutely adore Tetris Effect. I have not played this one on the Switch, but this is actually the first game that I ever played on the Xbox Series X. I know that's such a weird thing to say, but here I get this ultra powerful console day one, and well, Tetris Effect was available on Xbox Game Pass, and I went ahead and downloaded it. And next thing I know, I'd been playing this game for hours and hours because it's just an absolute blast. And then last but not least, Unpacking. This is another one that kind of surprised me that made this list. I'm really happy to see it did because this is just a good Zen experience that tells a story in a unique and different way. I know moving and everything is an absolute terrible experience, but somehow they made Unpacking a good game, and that really is just a testament all on its own. So yeah, I was really happy to see Nintendo showcase the best-selling independent games here for the Switch. I've said this before, but I really do believe that the Nintendo Switch is one of the best places to play independent games like this. Not necessarily because they have better independent games or anything like that, but rather because they just feel right on a console like the Nintendo Switch, especially in handheld mode. So because of this, it does seem like a lot of fans that like these type of games have jumped over to the Nintendo Switch, and it's really good to see that Nintendo is highlighting these games, not only because it shows us the best-selling games, but I mean, if you haven't tried one of these games out already, well, now you can kind of know about them, and you know, hopefully you'll go and check them out for yourself. And that's actually the next thing here, because Nintendo is holding a big Indie World holiday sale right now, so you can actually pick up several of these games at a discounted price over on the eShop. These games will be on sale through December 31st at 11:59 p.m. Pacific time. Let's go and take a look at the poll of the day, though, where I asked you all, what is your most anticipated game releasing in January of 2022? Now, January is a little bit of a slower month, as that typically is the case every single year, but there's still some really good games coming out in the first month of 2022, and as you can see here, most of you all are really excited about Pokemon Legends Arceus with 45% of the votes. Second place was actually Other. I did see several of you all comment about God of War on PC. Then third place here was Uncharted Legacy of Thieves Collection with 16%. Then fourth was Rainbow Six Extraction with 8%. And then you have Monster Hunter Rise for PC at 6%. So yeah, the runaway winner here was definitely Pokemon Legends Arceus. And yeah, I can definitely see why. Pokemon franchise in general is just massive. I love Pokemon myself, and this is something that the fans have been asking for such a long time, to have this more open world AAA style of game, and that's what Legends Arceus is. This one is being developed by Game Freak, and it's just a different formula than what we're used to seeing. Now, I'm a little optimistically cautious about this game just because I do like that classic formula, but I'm really interested to see how this one will turn out. I'm hoping for the best myself, but that's kind of the thing, because I'm not going to have to wait much longer, as this one will be releasing on January 28th of 2022. Cannot wait. Anyways, though, that's it for this episode, but if you liked the video, don't forget the bell notification and subscribe button for more content just like this. Also, if you'd like to support the channel through Patreon, thank you for making this content possible. Peace out.